attempts at further penetration of the German lines and knocked up in a third shot by the cloaked pack, which could fire three shots cloaked at the moment, but with the next patch only one shot. Question is how long until that patch is out. Further flamethrowers being equipped to the German pioneers, and MP40s going out for the Volkskund. There's certainly a lot more of an assault focus for the German troops. And in the north we see something out of the command tank, a kangaroo, and I'm sure someone will already be going boo hiss. How dare he. Certainly the kangaroo is a bit too cheap and a bit too strong at the moment, but with the next patch that will be dealt with. And we see sappers being stuffed into the kangaroo, the kangaroo itself being a Canadian ram tank with the turret and a lot of the insides removed to make a armored personnel carrier. Other units or tanks used for that would be priests, bishops, and I do believe kangaroos were stewards were used for this as well. Pioneers moving ahead, going to find themselves with a nasty surprise in a few seconds. Pierre fire landing among them but not doing any damage at all. And we see a panther on the way, and we see a Staghound armored car as well. The Staghound being a vicious little car, able to do a lot of damage, although the machine gun will receive a nerf with the next patch. And the half track has been changed into a Stuka Sofus, and we see a second machine gun emplacement to cover this victory point, which was never actually seized by Jona and is now probably going to be bit without his beyond his grasp, although if he does make a solid push he still should have a chance. In particular with this panther, if kept at long range, should be a threat to the kangaroo. And we see a grenadier team is being created while Fuchs grenadiers are regrouping in the main base. Currently Sawa the Hutt has certainly gained a small upper hand advantage. Then again, a quick thrust up right here will divide his territories and his troops, and certainly do a lot of damage, but again it seems like Jona is content to just sit back. Dangerous to be sure, and we hear Stuka rockets going off. Where will they go? Seems to be hitting these emplacements. Numerous infantry section troops going up in flames, and the mortar emplacement construction has been halted, although none of the other emplacements have suffered any major damage. Both sides taking it very slowly, carefully, not really trying to seize any territory. And again, I suspect Jona really ought to be doing this, put some pressure on the British commander instead of letting the British commander allow to gather forces at his leisure. Sabas doing some repairs on the Bofors AA cannon. And we see a small and opening fire on the Volksgrenadiers. Fun thing about the Bofors is that it's much more accurate at long range than it is close up. So if you want to be safe against it, a good move is actually to move your infantry close to it, not away from it. Captain seizing this high munitions point from the Wehrmacht commander, which unless dealt with will be a severe blow. And no doctrine yet for the Wehrmacht commander either. So let's return to Sabah the Hutt, who is currently ramming through with his Staghound, which has suffered heavy damage to anti-tank assets, trying to deal with the Stuka Sofus. Panzerstreck hitting the rear armor, and Staghound retreating with all haste. Main gun being inoperable at the moment. No doctrine either for Saba the Hutt either, and in fact not a lot from Saba. Awfully quiet as skirmishing is breaking out around the central victory point. Mortars trying to light fire, and further Stuka barrage killing the sapper team and doing some damage to the mortar emplacement teams. mortar rounds raining in on the German positions, and we have the commando doctrine up, and a glider is crashing in at this very moment, unleashing a deadly cargo of commandos right into the German line, slaughtering the pioneers in seconds with their Sten guns. And the pack is certainly going to suffer a just as grim fate, slaughtered by the commandos, who are now seizing the pack and finding themselves under heavy machine gun fire. Suppressed, but apparently able to move at a brisk pace nonetheless, and pinned even. One commando down. Stuka not being repaired, still hanging around at the front, and the Panther not really moving in either to do something. Seems to be a lack of coordination among the Kampfgruppe's troops, in fact. Should probably try and rectify that. Mortar fire raining in on an attempt at stopping the seizure of the fuel point. And seems like Saba is... Jona is slowly losing territory, in fact, without really trying anything to gain territory.
Has provided frontline troops with radio triangulation.
Nor is he attempting to seize any of the wrecks for munitions. Not good either. Or, in fact, seizing this MG42. Commandos, in fact, making it off with the Stuka. I mean, pack. Not Stuka. Although I suppose I want the Stuka to fire at it and decrew it, possibly. Yes, in fact, Stuka going out, taking out the pack crew. One commando, in fact, lying burning on the ground. Horrible death. Although the emplacements are still standing, the Stuka's fire so far not being awfully accurate. Willing and waiting. Kangaroo carrier number 2 on the field as well. No, nothing to really stuff in, although there is a sapper team nearby with Piats. Captain finding himself caught out in the open by a flamethrower team, but dashes away to safety. Panzer 4 on the field, no veterans yet for either infantry or tanks. Might want to consider that for Jona, though.
We are losing a strategic sector.
And another lull in the battle as both commanders seem to be thinking about to do a small attempt at seizing territory, but a kangaroo carrier filled with infantry commandos and a recon section crashes in and ruins that attempt. So far no overtly aggressive moves, mostly striking at the outermost territories of either commanders. Again, I think Jona should be attempting to actually make some attack on Saba and actually seize some of his territory, possibly even try to split up his forces, but again, not really doing it, not even attempting to do some reconnaissance and find out what the situation is. And veterancy up is, one is up for the Panzers, meaning they will have decreased penetration against them, I do believe. Recon section pinned, and Kangaroo finding himself under heavy fire from the Panzers and Panzer Shreks. Going to risk being knocked out, and engine is damaged, and another rearmor hit, but it is still not grouped up, still trying to escape, and now completely wrecked by a shot from the Panther commandos, seeking cover behind the wreck, but being dangerously close to being annihilated, retreating swiftly. And Saba seems to be leaning back and has gotten one of the abilities that allows him to see what the Wehrmacht commander is actually doing in his space. Noting he is getting veterancy 2 for his troops. Commander's gunning down the MP40 Volksgrenadiers. And we see an attack on the Wehrmacht commander's base. Kangaroo with Piats and a Staghound rushing directly. And the veterancy 2 Panzer and Panther rushing ahead. Now with a machine gunner on their tops. Although currently Panzer MG42s, the ones mounted, aren't really that effective. The only effective ones being on the Stuke and the Schutzwagen, at least in my opinion. Panther moving in, opening fire on the rear armor of the Kangaroo. Kangaroo trying to deal with it. Piat's quite effective against tanks with no side squares, although with the next patch a small few changes will happen, meaning they are less effective against infantry and skirted vehicles. Making a dash for safety now that the combined panzer force is there, threatening them. Removing the Stuka Sufus from the equation with Piet and gunfire, and MG42 team force retreat as well. Panther making a bad decision, moving into the close, quite tight quarters, and way too close into the range of the Piets. It's going to risk being blown up if it is not careful, and yup, completely blown up. Crewman ejected violently. Certainly not a wise move, and commanders moving ahead to secure another munitions point.
The arty lads have received their decoys,
and now we have a call-in artillery barrage and a decoy to confuse the enemy as well. And we see the first barrage going in here, trying to cover a 5 munitions point, a bit excessive I'd say, but not my decision to make. German pack once more recruited by commandos, providing fire support. Commandos dashing ahead for the central victory point, and I'd certainly say that at this moment Jona has definitely lost the initiative completely after having so graciously given it to Saba. And I'm not entirely sure what he's up to at the moment. No doctrine either, and another grenadier team trying to deal with the commandos who are seizing a munitions point once more. Panzer Force and Grenadier forcing away the commandos, but losing the central victory point in the process, and a demolition charge going down, making any attempt at seizing the victory point a very risky undertaking. Commandos being suppressed, taking some losses to the already depleted commando section. Artillery fire going down probably here. Or no, in fact down on the MG42 team, completely annihilating it and destroying the MG42 itself as well. Lots of artillery fire from Saba, and still no doctrine for Jona. Not much anything at all, in fact. Not entirely sure what his plan is. Grenadiers with Panzerschrecks moving out. Not dealing with the commandos though, just standing and looking, although now moving in. Commandos of 30th Corps, 1st Airborne Division forced to retreat, and further artillery barrage going in on the Grenadiers of Kampfgruppe Jona, who are not retreating and taking heavy losses and damage. Really should consider retreating before they are completely annihilated. Jona might want to work on his unit preservation skills a bit. Panzer IV taking heavy pack fire and forced to pull back into the safety of the empty barracks.